Sit down. You beat them.
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story. She always knew how to spark my ire.
Expect me to believe you are a loving father to Tamara after that scene in the courtyard?
You're free to believe whatever you wish, but she was always the apple of my eye. She had the run of the place, ask anyone. She'd ride the horses, hunt with the men, at times join them on their rounds. And they'd send for her when I flew into a rage, for only she could calm me.
Make it sound like she led a charmed life. If that's the case, why'd she run?
I'd hardly need you if I knew.
Your wife, how'd she make you angry? Too much salt in the soup? Socks never darned?
20 years we've known each other. She's seen me drunk and sober. She was there to greet me when I returned the victor. She was there to patch me up in defeat. Like no other, she knew where to press, where to pinch, so it would hurt.
You beat her? For that? For criticizing you?
Oh, Witcher, you haven't a clue, have you? Well, perhaps I shall tell you about it one day. One day, but not today.
You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Doesn't much matter now. I know how to find them.
How?
I know about the baby.
Anna and I. It wasn't as it seemed. Seems.
All right. I'm all ears. Tell me what happened. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
Signs of a fight in the room. Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Aye. We tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and the pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table, spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head. I blacked out. Don't know what happened next. When I came to, I was alone.
Tamara present for all this? She see you quarrel?
Through the doorway, perhaps. She didn't enter the room. Shame, too. Things might have turned out differently. The sight of her always calmed me.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber, and Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
Maybe you're doing, maybe not. But that amulet she wore could be important, or maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
What was I to do? Took it out and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born. Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.
I sympathize. I do.
Thank you. And know that I hope you find your Ciri.
Deal we made means I need to find Tamara and Anna first. Just so happens your unborn daughter might help us do that.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
Details you don't need to know. There's a bond of blood between this creature and your wife and daughter. I can use that bond to find them.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob, a guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Peller and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her, and I'll dig the grave at my threshold.
If it turns out we can't transform the botchling into a lubberkin, they can bury us in it. Handy either way. Need to tend to something first.
Be quick! And me? What am I to do in the meantime?
Sober up.
See, you're a man well traveled.
So Ciri was here. Ciri must have used these. Looks like she left in a hurry. The Natural Obscurity of Curses by Lydia van Bredevoort. Where'd Ciri get this? A dedication to the Baron and his wife. Seems they had friends in high places in Vizima.
Where did you come from?
A spinning top. Gritka's toy.
See, you're a man well traveled. So tell me, should I beat me wench once a week or oftener?
So you're Gretka?
I am. And you're Geralt.
How do you know?
Because you've white hair and a medallion shaped like a wolf. Ciri told me about you.
Look familiar?
My top. Where'd you find it?
Ciri's room.
We'd play in her room sometimes. I was sad one day, and Ciri carved it for me. Such a shame she had to leave.
You and Ciri talked a bit, didn't you?
We did.
Did she say where she was going, or what she came here to look for?
She said she was looking for you, and a sorceress. But you're here, so I guess she didn't find you. I wonder if she helped that friend of hers.
Ciri wanted to help a friend. Any idea who it was?
What do you mean, who? Her friend. She said he was in trouble and that she had to save him.
Do you know where Ciri is?
No. One day I brought her breakfast and she was already gone. The Baron told me she'd left.
Didn't ask where she'd gone?
I did. But he said I was too little and I wouldn't understand. But Ciri left me a gift.
A gift?
Yes, this. A green stone.
Beautiful as gifts go. Hide it well. Don't show it to anyone. It's worth a lot. Thanks, Gretka. Have fun.
But I'm not playing. I'm helping.
Well, ready?
The sooner we resolve this, the better. Best do it tonight, at midnight.
Then wait here with me. Near midnight, I'll take you to where I buried her.
Get word to the common folk. Ought to stay in their homes tonight and draw a line of salt outside their doors.
Do I take a shovel to dig up the grave?
Take it. You'll need it, but not for that.
A bit further. Follow me.
You give the child a name?
No. Why would we?
Mistake. Names are powerful seals.
Here's the spot.
Chose a lovely spot.
Damn it, will you relent? I'm plowing now I've done wrong.
Good. The grave's dug up and empty.
What's that mean?
Botchling's on the prowl.
Look!
Take it in your arms, quick.
But if it goes Garrity, it'll bite us in the arse before we know it!
Keep screaming and it will turn rabid. It's calm for now.
Bloody hell! What happens when it gets plowing restless?
It'll bite through your jugular, and you'll bleed to death before I can help. Tell me if it starts wriggling. I'll calm it with magic. Pick it up. Take it in your arms.
Merciful gods!
Back to the fortress.
What? With this?
As I recall, you were the one wanted to test the old legends, change it into a lubricant.
Oh, fuck. Come down. We must bury it. Speak afterwards.
Bury it under the threshold. If the tales are true, by tomorrow it'll be a leprechaun. From then on, it'll watch over your house and help me find your family.
Here's the spot. Damn.
Good. Nick, what's much? Take the key. Back to the fortress.
What? With this?
As I recall, you were the one wanted to test the old legends and change it into a lubricant.
Oh, fuck.
The tales are true. By tomorrow, it'll be a leprechaun. From then on, I'll watch over your house and help me find your family. More coming. Need to hurry.
With it, but look, it's a pretty balance.
Not bad.
Chosen a name?
No.
So think of one. It's important.
It's a girl. What would Anna have named her? What now?
Repeat after me. By the powers of earth and sky.
By the powers of earth and sky.
By the world that was to be your home.
By the world that was to be your home.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
Forgive me? You who came, but who I did not embrace.
I name thee, say her name, and embrace thee as my daughter.
I name thee, Daya, and embrace thee as my daughter.
Good. Now bury the body.
What now?
In one day's time, Daya should turn into a lubberkin. I'll stay here and wait. You go home.
I'll wait with you.
Out of the question.
But that's my child. And the guilt, the responsibility for all this, lies with me.
Time for parental impulses? It's long past. Besides, nothing else you can do here.
But...
No buts. Just Witcher's work left to do here. Gotta wait a day and a night for the botchling to turn into a lubberkin. That's it. Go home. And try not to drink yourself stupid again. By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Daya. Lead me to those bound to you by blood.
Assist you.
Wouldn't mind.
light one. Looks like you got soused last night too.
Hey there. Fancy.
We've gathered.
See ya.
Lord in this foot. What did I do to deserve your company?
By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Dea. Lead me to those bound to you by blood.
Fucking shit!
Ugly bastard. Sure wasn't lavender they kept in there. Might be worth looking around, though. Clothing. They change in here. A bracelet. One of them must have dropped it. Horseshoe. No way a pitch burner could afford a horse. Both were here. I'm going the right way. Wants to show me something more. What do we have here? Bones have been here a while. Chewed on the saddle. Necrophages will eat anything these days. Giant claws. Wasn't a necrophage made these marks. Horseshoes missing. Is this the animal that lost one in the smokehouse? Head torn clear off. Takes incredible strength. Must have been attacked by a powerful beast. Surprised him. Hope they got away. Trail goes on. Good thing it doesn't end here. Fisherman's hut. Seems she wants me to take a closer look.
Who's that?
At the room. Go on now.
What you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure, not even passing through. Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
That sir came at night, right, Mummy?
Quiet, boy!
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough, no point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir, but you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is hoy. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Anna, that's another tale.
Though anywhere's better than the crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I mean. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
Where'd the girl go?
Sorry.
Because I'm not.
Tamara.
Though anywhere's better.
What?
Cause...
What happened to Tamara's mother?
T'were like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of you. Moon had arisen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. But then I saw it. Fiery marks on her hands.
What marks?
These, well, like burned on with hot iron. On the palms, inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. These hot and glowing, as if they burn with raw fire.
Fine, what happened next?
Grew even darker. Seemed someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden, and then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat, and before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'were the only reason we escaped. The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I'd a debt. Owed Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara alerted, brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me a time of war and contempt's come, a time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman.
Crying shame we couldn't save Mrs. Anna in the end.
Thanks for your help.
The lady, she'll be all right in the end, won't she?
I'll do what I can to see that she is. Diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace.